Welcome, welcome. I want to thank you all for taking time today to be here for a very important cause. My name is Michael McLarney. I'll be your MC today, but it's not about me, of course. It's about the fabulous people that are lined up to support this. I want to start with bringing on Norm DePasquale, who is co-chair of Ontario Place for All, for a land acknowledgement. Thank you. Norm.
Thank you for coming today. Ontario Place is located in Tikaronto, now known as Toronto, which in Mohawk means where there are trees standing in the water. Today, Tikaronto is covered under Treaty 13 and the Williams Treaties. It is the traditional territories of many First Peoples, including the Mississaugas of the Credit, the Anishinaabe, the Chippewa, the Haudenosaunee, and the Wendat peoples. As we gather here today, these nations continue to experience ongoing colonization and displacement, where land acknowledgements are offered in place of land itself. This territory is part of the Dish with One Spoon Wampum Belt Covenant, a treaty made between the Anishinaabe, Mississaugas, and Haudenosaunee, where nations entered into an agreement to protect the land and responsibly care for its resources in harmony together. As settlers, newcomers, refugees, and Indigenous people, we have all been invited into this treaty in the spirit of peace, friendship, and respect. We are also mindful of broken treaties that persist across Turtle Island today and recognize our responsibilities as treaty people to engage in meaningful, continuous process of truth and reconciliation with all our relations. We remember those who came involuntarily, particularly those brought to these lands as a result of the transatlantic trade, slave trade, and slavery. The city was built on stolen land and stolen labor of Black, Indigenous, and racialized people. What we now refer to as Canada was also built on the labor of many immigrant and migrant communities. From the transcontinental railroad to farming and food production, the country heavily relied and continues to on the talent, skill, and hard work of racialized people. In exchange, many of them are denied residence, and they continue to go through punishing immigration experiences and perpetuating racial disparities. By being on this land, we are all responsible for upholding its treaties. Treaty agreements were made to last, as long as the sun shines, the grass grows, and rivers flow. We invite you to learn about Indigenous nations that care for the land you are on and where you might come from. Visit native-land.ca to learn more.
Thank you very much, Norm. We'll have a full introduction for Norm later on. But first, I want to just give a little bit of an overview. We're here as Ontario Place for All. We're all very, very concerned about the future of this beautiful stretch of land, this jewel in the crown of Toronto and of Ontario, and make sure that it's shaped and directed in a way that's ideal and accessible for everybody. The theme being that public interest must prevail, not corporate interest, and that it's about transparency, accountability, and accessibility. I think those are the key themes we're looking at today in making sure that Ontario Place truly stays a place for everybody. Before we get to the main program, of course, there are some housekeeping details. I want to let you know there's actually a nice food station right there by the entrance behind us. There are washrooms on the east side here. One of the doors doesn't work too well, but they're all good. And there's more washrooms on the West Islander if you're up for the hike. So that's some of the stuff to think about there. And I want to start by mentioning that our first speaker today is Ken Greenberg. So please, I want to introduce Ken. Ken is a principal at Greenberg Consultants. He's an urban designer, teacher, writer, and former director of urban design and architecture for the City of Toronto. For over 4 years, he's played a pivotal role in public and private assignments in urban settings throughout North America and Europe. He's devoted to focusing on and rejuvenating downtowns, waterfronts, and neighborhoods. Ken's also been involved in campus master planning, regional growth management, and new community planning. So please, a big hand for Norm. For Ken. My notes, who wrote these? Come on, Ken, get up here, thank you.
Thanks, Mike. I'm not quite so young, so it's 40 years, not 4 years. I've been at it a little bit longer. So welcome to Ontario Place. This is a place that we have been repeatedly told for the last little while is dead, is derelict, nobody comes here, it's disposable, and it's up for grabs. So just look around you. I mean, aside from all of us gathered here for Ontario Place for All, I'm sure you've noticed all the people using Ontario Place as a park and surrounding us in all directions. I am a proud member of Ontario Place for All, and we are here today to say emphatically no to those assertions. We're here to celebrate an important birthday that we couldn't celebrate during the years of COVID, hence 50 plus 2, to show our care and to come to the rescue of a valuable place at risk at the hands of the very provincial government that created it. I also bring greetings from David Crombie, who is very sorry he could not make it, but who is with us today in spirit. So how did it come to this pass? 50 plus 2 years ago, we had visionary leadership at the province, inspired by Expo 67, which was a great moment for Canada, where we celebrated our emergence as a country, our centennial year. We created something in Montreal which welcomed the world in an extraordinary way. And Ontario was inspired by that. And two progressive conservative premiers, John Robarts, followed by Bill Davis, had the idea of creating something on Lake Ontario that would be in the spirit of what they had seen at Expo 67. So it opened in 1971. Most importantly, it was about us. It was about Ontario. Who we were, our land, our people, our creativity, what we were able to create. It was a place to show us, to show Ontarians, to ourselves. It was also meant to be fun, but it was serious fun. So in aid of this, the provincial government reached out to two of the greatest design talents in our midst at the time, architect Eberhard Zeidler and landscape architect Michael Huff. Eb Zeidler was working with new forms of building, a very expressive architecture, which was based on exposing structure and showing a way of building that was done in very few places in the world. The only other built example of the kind of thing that he did with the pods and the cinesphere is actually the Centre Pompidou in Paris. There are very few others in the world, and it has been recognized by the World Monuments Fund. Michael Huff was a great pioneer in design with nature, landscape ecology, in working to create the islands that we're on here with wind, with wave action, with contouring landforms, that slope that you're sitting on, was kind of his way of creating a place where we could be on the edge of the lake in comfort. They had never worked together before. This was the first collaboration. And when you put what each of them was doing, each of their highly experimental work together, it created something quite unique. You had Eberhard Zeidler's pods on the stilts, resting lightly on the land and water, in a way that had not been seen before, and a new way of occupying our lakefront, not the hard seawall that you see everywhere else, which had existed previously along the edge of Exhibition Place, but the kind of soft contoured landscape touching the water that you see around us here. It was pretty terrific. And in the first years, people loved it. But then something very strange happened. The government did not know, did not understand what had been created. Was it a theme park or a new kind of waterfront park? Or was it, as our premier likes to keep saying, a prime piece of real estate to be monetized? So there were then followed decades of neglect, of speculation, of many studies by accounting firms figuring out, or trying to figure out, how can we make money out of this real estate and denying it as a park. And so the decades of neglect became a self-fulfilling prophecy. Ontario Place deteriorated. And then the speculation became even more rampant. Should we build condos? Should we build a casino? So this had people pretty exercised. And then in 2012, a panel was convened led by former Mayor John Tory. And John Tory's report said something very interesting. No, he said, it is an iconic waterfront park. And I quote, no casinos, no condos. So slowly, thank you, John Tory. So slowly work began on revitalizing Ontario Place. And by 2017, this park, Trillium Park, was created, and it was proof of concept. It was true to the original spirit of the Michael Huff legacy. It had significant Indigenous involvement. I'm sure you noticed the moccasin signifiers when you walked through the gates. And there were future phases planned. This was intended to keep going west across Ontario Place. And despite its neglected state, over a million people per year kept coming to Ontario Place and using it as a park. And that was even more essential, I think, as we noticed during the time of COVID. But then something else happened. After the provincial election in 2018, that work was aborted, it was stopped, and a massive campaign of disinformation began. We had drive-by visits by a number of provincial cabinet ministers who came down to the site, looked out the windshield of their cars and said, it's a wasteland. Nobody goes there. Nothing can be salvaged. And those are all quotes. Shortly after that, a secretive RFP was issued to developers with the goal to privatize Ontario Place as a series of attractions behind paywalls. And the idea, what the brief said in the RFP, is you could make tabula rasa with few exceptions. Everything was fair game. It even said, if you can believe it, that Trillium Park, the 7.5 acres that we're on now, could be demolished and simply replaced with an equivalent amount of green space somewhere else on the site. There were apparently 37 proposals, 37 responses to the RFP, but we never saw them because of the secrecy. Three selected firms emerged. One of them was the infamous Therme Mega Spa on the West Island. In fact, in replacing the West Island in its entirety, Live Nation expansion, and a third company called EcoRecreo from Montreal, which has since dropped out. What was interesting is that none of them were from Ontario. So I could spend a half an hour talking about the problems with the Mega Spa, but suffice it to say, it's way too big. It's the size of the BMO Field Stadium. So in your mind's eye, if you can picture the stadium as a box, lift it up, move it across Lakeshore Boulevard, and put it on top of occupying the entirety of the West Island, that's how big it is. It's too private, it's too expensive, $40 for admission, it's internalized, it's highly subsidized, something like $650 million of taxpayer money. It requires cutting down 850 trees. It dwarfs and blocks the Xylopods and Cinesphere, and it relies on a 2,100 car parking garage paid for by us. It's an incredible example of climate denial. I liken it to the indoor ski hill in Dubai, building this gigantic structure all under glass with palm trees on Lake Ontario and completely sealed from our waterfront. You can't get out. Once you're inside, there's no way to access the waterfront. But most of all, it has nothing to do with us, the original vision of Ontario Place. It interrupts an intergenerational project, which we have all been involved in, of reclaiming our great waterfront on Lake Ontario, our irreplaceable treasure stretching from Coots Paradise in Hamilton to the Scarborough Bluffs and beyond, and intended to be for the public. There is a painful contrast to what is happening on the other side of downtown across the harbor, where the Don River comes into Lake Ontario, and where a magnificent $1.2 billion project paid for by all three levels of government, is underway to provide floodproofing for downtown, at the same time a magnificent park system. And here's what's interesting, it's being carried out by Waterfront Toronto, an agency which has been around for 21 years, pretty much since chasing an Olympic bid, which didn't happen. All three levels of government work together, including our provincial government. And to make it even more poignant, this park was created by Waterfront Toronto working with Infrastructure Ontario, the very arm of the provincial government that is working on occupying the West Island with the mega spa. So it's a strange set of circumstances. And then, to top it off, out of the blue, we just had an announcement about shutting down the Ontario Science Centre and moving it to be nestled up against the mega spa. So not only is Eb Zeidler's work under threat, great architect Eb Zeidler, but the other great architect of the era, Raymond Moriyama, is also on the chopping block. So we heard the same drumbeat, the same method, starve and neglect for many years, and then claim it can't be salvaged. No one was consulted. Nobody asked for that to happen. It was terrible news for the communities of Flemington Park and Thorncliffe Park, for the staff, for the people who were running the Science Center, for the scientific community. And on top of that, it turns out that what the Premier was calling for, which is building on the floodplain, we learned from the Conservation Authority that you can't do that, that that is land at risk. And the same strange blind spot for the modern legacy of 20th century architecture. So here's what's going on. The PC party is attacking its own legacy, which is very odd. These two mistakes taken together only compound the damage, creating more problems at both ends of the Ontario line. But I want us to take heart, because generational mistakes have been stopped before. There is power in the public, and the public is speaking out. In 1972, 1 year after Ontario Place opened, Premier Bill Davis stood up in the Ontario legislature and announced that he was stopping the Spadina Expressway. That was a pivotal moment. Yeah. And we need another one of those. In 2011, after the municipal election, there was an attempt to abort the plans for the Portlands, for the Lower Donlands, and to replace the park system that's now being created with a luxury yacht club and a mega mall working in secrecy with an Australian developer. And that too was stopped by an organization called Code Blue, which, and Code Blue is actually what has led us to Ontario Place for All. So there is a better way. It's not just what we are against, but what we are for. And very shortly, Ontario Place for All will offer its proposals for a fresh look. And this is based on the fact that, ironically, the Ontario Line subway connects and provides access 15 stops, 15.6 kilometers, between two of our greatest natural assets, the Don River Valley and Lake Ontario, providing access to nature at both ends for the people of Ontario and the people of our city. And so what we're going to be looking at is how can we leverage that access at a time when our relationship to the natural environment has never been more important, along with our need for affordability and inclusion. How do we creatively use and adapt these great provincial assets instead of discarding them? So please stay tuned. But today, we are here to celebrate a birthday, and so I invite you to have fun, and please join us in attempting to rescue Ontario Place. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Ken, for that that great background and for really explaining to us just the road to getting to where we are today. Now I want to introduce, and I'll also add that I just rode out to Port Hope yesterday on my bicycle, and I tell you, the waterfront from here to there is spectacular. So this has got to be an important part of that whole continuum of Ontario's relationship with the lake. And it's just so important to preserve that. Now, I want to introduce now officially the man who's really behind a lot of what's going on today, Norm DePasquale. Norm is a true community activist. He's a school board trustee, an information technologist, and his background is very rich. He led the No Jets TO fight against jets at the Island Airport. And today he's the co-chair of Ontario Place for All. Let's face it, Norm cares deeply about our waterfront, our city, and the future of our planet. Folks, a warm welcome, please, for Norm DePasquale.
Thanks, everyone, for coming out today. So we're actually here on the 52nd birthday of Ontario Place. Ontario Place opened May 22nd, 1971. So we're standing here precisely at the 52-year anniversary of Ontario Place. It's amazing to celebrate in person. We didn't get to do this for the 50th anniversary, so it's awesome that we're all here. We have a cake, obviously. This wouldn't be a birthday without a cake, and we can't wait to uncork that later with all of you. We have a table behind you where you can get pins, you can get signs, flyers, all kinds of stuff, stickers, and you can also tap to donate there if you're so inclined. So thank you all for coming today. And I also want to thank the mayoral candidates who have come today. So just over there we have Kiri Vadivalu's people. You can go get a flyer there if you like. We have mayoral, and then working my way this way, I see mayoral candidate Anthony Peruzza right there. You can give a wave if you like. There he is. We have Olivia Chow just over here in purple. And I've also seen mayoral candidate Chris Langenfeld somewhere, and Gru is here somewhere. Councillor Josh Mallow, who's also running for mayor, is right here. Thanks for coming, Josh. And we, as was mentioned, we also have Chris Langenfeld and Gru, who are also present running for mayor. Give a wave if you guys are around. Councillor Malik couldn't be here today, but... Oh, yes. Oh, yes, and we have Mike Schreiner, and we actually have representation from all three opposition parties from Queen's Park. Isn't that awesome? They are part of the people power and the opposition to the mega spa that nobody wants. Councillor Malik couldn't be here today, but we're super grateful for her support at City Hall. Tom Davidson from her office is somewhere around. He could give a wave if he is here. Tom Davidson's over here, so please connect with him. And, you know, we are all and they are totally on team Stop the Mega Spa. So I'm very grateful for Councillor Malik and their team. Also, totally grateful to have musical guests Sarah Harmer, The Rio Statics, and Dom Louie playing a little later today, which is super awesome. And that's all I really wanted to say, and I'll pass it right back to you, Michael.
Also want to mention one other person that's here today. A shout out, Michael Huff was mentioned earlier, the original landscape architect for Ontario Place. His wife, who survives him, Bridget Huff, is here. Big wave, where's Bridget? She's out there. I want to thank her for being here as well. Terrific, there she is, fantastic. So. That's great. And yes, it's birthday time. It's 50 years plus two for COVID since Ontario Place was started. I'll just wait for the vibrance that is the lakefront to pass us by. And it's a real pleasure now. We're going to have a birthday. We got birthday cake. So we're the kids. We want to make sure we got cake for everybody. But first, and right after that, we're going to choose Sarah Harmer to come on up and sing a song for us. So, please, let's sing a little bit of happy birthday first, okay? We good for happy birthday? Woo! Can we do a little happy birthday here, folks? You ready? Ready to give it a go? Okay. And a one, and a two.
Michael, are you doing this song?
We're doing happy birthday?
Bring the cake over here.
Okay, photo op. We got the cake coming. Come on. Woo! Come on. Let's have a big hand for the cake and for 50 years plus two for COVID. For Ontario Place, the Ontario Place for everybody. There you go. Look at that cake. Now there's a cake. Fabulous. All right, and a one, and a two,
And a three. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Ontario Place. Happy birthday to you.
All right. Two. Okay, all right. Sorry, guys. We're serving the cake after the rally. Okay, I came for the cake and the T-shirt, but, you know, it's all going to happen. So just want you to hang tough. We've got a great program lined up for you today. And some really, as Norm pointed out, a lot of people that are involved in this at the political level, some mayoral candidates here, lots of city councilors, ask them the tough questions, challenge them to make sure they're working on your behalf, on our behalf, to see that Ontario Place is developed and curated in a way that's good for everybody. Alrighty, so as I say, we're just gonna let the fabulous Sarah Harmer set up, and I'm gonna give you a little bit of an intro on just who this incredible talent is. Truly, one of the most distinctive voices in Canadian rock and folk, and she's just been part of the Canadian and Toronto scene for so many years. She's established herself among a pantheon of legendary female singer-songwriters. Her name spoken in the same breath as Joni Mitchell, Sarah McLachlan, Sylvia Tyson, and Kate and Annie McGarrigle. Sarah is an environmental activist who in 2005 founded PERL, P-E-R-L, Protecting Escarpment Rural Land. So her involvement in what goes on in Ontario goes deep. This PERL is an organization which campaigns to protect the Niagara Escarpment from a proposed gravel development, which would seize some of the land that she knows and loves, turn into gravel pits. To support the organization, she and her acoustic band embarked on a tour of the escarpment, hiking the Bruce Trail, and performing at theaters and community halls in towns along the way. There's even a documentary made of it called Escarpment Blues. You might want to look that one up. And you know what? Here's cool. Sarah used to work at Ontario Place. All right. Yeah. So, you all set? Sarah is here now, ready to go. Please welcome Juno Award winner, Sarah Harmer.
Wow, thank you so much, Michael. It's great to be back. It's been a few decades for me. I thought this one, it just goes without saying, this song should be part of the event today. Speaking of Joni Mitchell. Well, they paved paradise, put up a parking lot. No, they didn't. They're not gonna happen. With a big motel, a boutique, and a swinging hot spot. Now, don't it always seem to go that you don't know what you got till it's gone? They paved paradise, put up a parking lot. Well, they put all the trees, put them in a tree museum. And they charge all the people a dollar and a half just to see them. Oh, it always seemed to go that you don't know what you got till it's gone. They paved paradise, put up a parking lot. Hey, farmer, farmer, put away the DDT now. Leave me the spots on the apples, just leave me the birds and the bees. Don't it always seem to go that you don't know what you got till it's gone? They paved paradise, put up a parking lot. Late last night, I heard the screen door slam. And a big yellow taxi took away my old man. Don't it always seem to go that you don't know what you got till it's gone? They paved paradise, put up a parking lot. But it's not gonna happen here, is it? Paved paradise, don't put up a parking lot. Somebody's dream, but not our dream. They paved paradise, they won't put up a parking lot. Thank you, I'll be back in a bit.
That's fantastic. Thank you so much, Sarah. Another big hand for Sarah Harmer, folks, and a great song, really appropriate for the day. Thank you so, so much. I want to, now bring back Norm DePasquale. Norm's got some prepared remarks. This is Norm's show. We want him up here to really share what's going on with the Ontario Place for All movement. So, Norm, welcome back.
Okay, so now we're going to get the rally section of this underway. So now we're going to use all of your energy. Thank you for being here today. Let's bring the people power that's going to win this fight. So thank you first to Sarah Harmer for kicking off the rally portion with a bang. And if you guys can, well, there's some Ontario Place signs back there. Maybe it's a bit too far of a walk for you, but we're going to do a little rally here. So I'm going to start with a couple of chants. So I hope you all can figure it out and repeat after me. So whose Ontario Place is this? Our Ontario Place. Whose public space?
Our public space.
Whose waterfront?
Our waterfront.
Whose science center?
Our science center.
Okay, here comes another one. Hey, hey, ho, ho. Therme Spa has got to go. Hey, hey, ho, ho. Therme Spa has got to go. Hey, hey, ho, ho. Therme Spa has got to go. Hey, hey, ho, ho. Therme Spa has got to go. Okay, I got another hit for you. When Ontario Place is under attack, what do? Stand up, fight back. When public space is under attack, what do? Stand up, fight back. When Science Center is under attack, what do? Stand up, fight back. When West Island is under attack, what do?
Stand up, fight back.
When 850 trees are under attack, what do?
Stand up, fight back.
When birds and animals are under attack, what do?
Stand up, fight back.
Amazing energy, guys. That sounded fantastic. Give yourselves a round of applause. Well done. Now, I would like to introduce the leader of the Ontario Green Party. The Ontario Green Party has shown an incredible nimbleness, and they have been there with us fighting against the mega spot Ontario Place, and I'm very grateful. I just want to say that, Mike. Thank you so much. And this is Mike Schreiner, the leader of the Ontario Green Party and MPP for Guelph. Mike?
Thanks, Norm, and thank you all for being here today. This is what people power looks like. And we need to send a clear message to Doug Ford that public spaces need to be held in public hands. Our hands. It's on our Ontario Place. Not Therme's Ontario Place, not Doug Ford's Ontario Place. And so I want to be crystal clear, and I know we're working across party lines to make this happen. We will cancel this contract. It is outrageous. You know, it was bad enough when we first heard that the Ford government was going to privatize our public space. It was bad enough when we learned that we were going to be subsidizing hundreds of millions of dollars to build a parking lot for these folks. But it was outright disgusting and outrageous when we learned that Ford is signing a 95-year lease.
Shame.
Shame. Shame. The only thing that's comparable to this is the disastrous decision to sign a 99-year lease for Highway 407. We can't let that happen here. We will not let that happen here. So from the bottom of my heart, I want to thank Norm and the team, Ontario Place for All, and I want to thank each and every one of you for standing up to keep public land in public hands to ensure that the people of this province and of this city have access to the waterfront, public access to the waterfront. I want to close by saying I have such fond memories of bringing my two daughters, who are now grown up, but bringing my two daughters here to Ontario Place and having so many wonderful family-friendly days here. And we are gonna fight like hell to ensure that this place remains a family-friendly place, not a privatized space for luxury spa goers. So the fight continues. We're going to fight with you. We're going to work with my colleagues across party lines. And we're going to cancel this contract. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you, Mike Schreiner. That was brilliant. And I just want you to know, I first met Mike a couple of years ago when there was a tour, a walk through here. Our friend Bruce Van Deaton, who does walks of Ontario Place and does walks through the CNE, recommend if you ever want to do a Jane Jacobs walk with Bruce. It's a brilliant thing to do. And I first met Mike at a walk through Ontario Place. Bruce said, it's going to be a parade through Ontario Place. I thought, a Schreiner parade? I looked for my Fez and my tiny bicycle. Wrong phrase. It was Mike Schreiner from. So thank you, Mike, for being here. And also, if you want to have some understanding of just how successful Ontario Place is, never mind the banners and the signs and the video. Just look around you at all the people here. That's success. That's a place that really works. Fabulous. Congratulations to everybody that makes use of this place. Next, I want to introduce Merritt Stiles. Merritt is the leader of the Ontario New Democratic Party and leader of the opposition since 2023. She's a critic for intergovernmental affairs, and she's here today to lend her support to Ontario Place for All. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Merritt Stiles. Thank you.
Hello, everybody. How are we doing? What a beautiful day, right? Mother Nature smiling down on all of us because we're standing up for the right things, aren't we? I'm Merritt Stiles, and I am the leader of Ontario's official opposition. Thank you. And I'm here with Jessica Bell, MPP for University Rosedale. Woo! Utila Carbache, MPP for Parkdale High Park. And the MPP for this space right here, Chris Glover, MPPs for Spadina, Fort York. I want to start by thanking Ontario Place for All and to Norm for doing this extraordinary organizing work, right? I mean, look at what they have accomplished today. So we're here to celebrate this cherished, this iconic space. But we're also here to tell Doug Ford that Ontario Place belongs to all of us. All of us. I want to say, as I'm walking along here, what am I remembering? I'm thinking about all the times I've taken my little kids for walks down here when they were small, playing at the water park, walking our dogs. Maybe some of you are here for the first time. Maybe some of you have been here with your grandparents. Maybe you've been here for generations now. Well, we're here because we're going to stand up and make sure that this land is protected for all future generations. I want to tell you that every day I have the privilege of sitting across the aisle from Doug Ford. Now, I know some of you may not think that's a privilege, but I look at it that way because I see my role as holding this government to account every single day. And I know, thank you, and I know that the questions that I get to ask are the questions many of you wish you could ask him every day. And we have been asking this government every day. We've been asking them to share the details of the deal with Therme every single day. And have they done it? No. Shame. We're asking them why they're going to subsidize a private, luxury, Austrian conglomerate by building a $650 million parking lot. Shame. And you know what they say? Nothing. Nothing. I ask them why they're proceeding with another deal with a bunch of Ford government insiders, with the chair of Ontario Place, who is appointed by the Ford government and a prominent conservative and donor, behind closed doors, negotiating right now to continue to sell off more of Ontario Place. And we are not getting the answers we want, so you know what we did? We tabled a motion and we said, take it off the table. Cancel the plan. Ontario Place belongs to Ontarians, right? Because Doug Ford and the Conservatives, they think Ontario Place is their personal playground. And they think that the Ontario Treasury is their piggy bank. And the only ones they want to invite to the sand pit are their conservative friends, our wealthy developers, and donors to the Conservative Party. And we're not going to have that. This is not just about a luxury spa. It's not just about the deals that are being done with Thermé and others behind closed doors. This truly is about the kind of province and the kind of city we want to have in this, right here in this place and in Ontario, right? It's about our vision for what we want our province to be. And I want to thank again everybody who showed up today to stand up for Ontario Place. This is not the end, this is the beginning. But I want to tell you, we are on it at Queen's Park, and we're going to continue to bring that fight into the legislature every single day until we get this government to back away from this terrible plan. So everyone, enjoy the beautiful day we're having. Celebrate this jewel that we have here. Remember that we're not just fighting for the use of this space for ourselves, but it's for all of our grandchildren and their grandchildren and their grandchildren, because we are the ones who are going to protect this space, just like so many others have over so many years. And we're going to make sure that Doug Ford backs away, and then in 3 years, my friends, we're going to take him out. Thank you very much.
I want to thank Merrick very much for that. Really a big hand. Thank you so much. Big hand, round of applause. And she was supported there by Mary Margaret McMahon and Abdutila Karposh, both in the government as well. I say in the government, listen to me. Let's check my notes here. Mary Margaret is the MPP for Beaches, East York, and she's here. Thank you for being here. And Butilic is MPP for Parkdale High Park. So again, thank you for being here. Alrighty. No, she's going to pass. Mary Margaret's next, right?
Yeah.
I got Mary Margaret next. Okay, alrighty. Just let me welcome Mary Margaret McMahon, MPP for Beaches, East York. She's a liberal critic for environment, conservation and parks, tourism, culture and sports, seniors and accessibility in public and business service delivery. Wow, I'm glad you got time to even be here today with that kind of a CV. Ms. McMahon is the Ontario Liberal Caucus critic for the environment, conservation and parks, tourism, culture and sports, seniors and accessibility and public and business service delivery. Ladies and gentlemen, Mary Margaret McMahon, welcome.
It down. Thanks. Thank you so much. Thank you for having me. Thanks to Ontario Place for All, Norm, Cindy, Suzanne, and everyone else. I've never been to a rally. I've been to many, many rallies in my life, dragged my kids to them, but I've never been to one with cake. So this is pretty exciting. Happy birthday, Ontario Place. You're a little bit younger than me, but I am thrilled to be here. I remember coming here as a kid. With my brothers, it's amazing. The reason I got back into this wild world of politics was because of the climate emergency. My brothers call me the eco-witch of the East. And I take that as a compliment, actually. And so everything I'm looking at, I look through that lens, and I know you do too, because we're in a climate emergency, it's 2023. And so when I think of buildings, I think we need to ensure that they're all built sustainably. So, looking at mass timber, energy efficiency, Toronto Green Standard, not glass boxes on the lake, right? And when I think of transit, transportation, I think of active transportation. I think of safe cycling infrastructure, safe infrastructure for pedestrians, and investment in transit. Not paving over paradise, which Sarah is not going to let us do. None of us are going to do that for a bloody parking lot. The world in 2023 is not all about the almighty car. And, you know, we need to ensure we are protecting and preserving our tree canopy. Honestly, the extreme heat is upon us and we're going to all bake. And it's not going to be good, but we need to preserve our old growth trees and have a fabulous succession planting program with non-invasive species, native species. Look at around us, 850 trees coming down, no way, no way. And last but not least, I'm okay with a second science center here, a second one, a mini one, a satellite one, focusing on ecology and the Great Lakes. But leave the gem in Thorncliffe, leave that gem there. Right? And let's all work together, as Mike Schreiner says, across party lines to keep Ontario Place for Ontarians. Hear, hear. Thanks.
Brilliant. Thank you so much for that. That was brilliant. Next, I want to bring on Chris Glover. Chris Glover is the MPP for Spadina, Fort York. And Chris was elected to the Legislative Assembly of Ontario in 2018. Re-elected in 2022, and he's representing Spadina Fort York. He's the official opposition critic for Democratic Reform, Technology, Development, and Innovation. Ladies and gentlemen, Chris Glover.
Thank you so much. Okay, so my name is Chris Glover. I'm the MPP for Spadina Fort York, and Ontario Place is in Spadina Fort York. Welcome to the riding. Look, I am so honored to be here with the leader of the Ontario NDP, Marit Stiles, with my colleagues Butila Carpoche and Jessica Bell. And I just got back from Minden, Ontario, where I was with MPP Jennifer French, and we were fighting to save the Minden Emergency Room, which is ground... Thank you. It's ground zero on the fight against the privatization of our public healthcare system. This Ford Conservative government, they have three principles. They want to sell off public assets like Ontario Place. They want to privatize public services like our public health care. And they want to shovel as many taxpayer dollars into the pockets of private for corporations like Thermé. And we have to stop them. This place opened in 1971, and I gotta admit, I'm actually old enough. I was here in the year that it came, that it opened. My parents brought me here. And this place was designed by Eb Zeidler, the architect, by Michael Huff, the landscape architect. And the Children's Village was designed by Eric McMillan. He's the guy who invented the ball pit. So if you have ever enjoyed a ball pit, or your kids or your grandkids have ever enjoyed a ball pit, that's due to Eric McMillan. It's due to this place. And all of these architects and designers were Ontario-based. This was a place to celebrate Ontario. And I just want you to, I want to acknowledge, we have Ontario Place royalty in the audience today. We have Jane Zeidler, the wife of Eb Zeidler, right over here. And Margie Zeidler, his daughter, is here as well. And we have Bridget Huff, the wife of Michael Huff, is here. So I want to thank you and your families and your husbands for all the work that you did to make Ontario Place the iconic treasure that it is and the iconic treasure that we are fighting to preserve against the Ford government. Thank you so much for allowing me to speak today. Have a wonderful day and happy birthday, Ontario Place.
And thank you, Chris. Chris always has the best hat as well on the Queen's Park. So I just want to now introduce our final speaker before we move into the music and the party again. And my pleasure now to introduce Okay, oh, Sydney's here as well. Okay, that's right, Sydney, that's right. I got two more speakers, actually. So just give me a second here. We've got Emmy, and I've got his notes right here, so sorry about that while I mush around, okay? This is what we do. We just make it up as we go, folks, so bear with me. Emmy Agulu is a young person, and it's just so great to see young people so involved in this activity and in this kind of movement. And I want to thank you for being here, for your interest and your passion. Emmy is with the Toronto Foundation for Youth Involvement in Politics. So the Toronto Foundation for Youth Involvement in Politics. So any other young people out there looking for a way to get involved, you want to talk to this guy. And it's pretty incredible what he does. He's an organizer. He's also involved, a communications lead, actually, for Ontario Place for All. And he's a youth activist for an organization called Engage. Alrighty. Ladies and gentlemen, friends of Ontario Place, everyone here, please welcome Emmy Agulu. Welcome. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Emmy Agulu, and I'm a member of Ontario Place for All. Thank you so much for all joining us here today at Trillium Park to celebrate the 50th anniversary of Ontario Place, a cherished landmark that embodies the spirit of our city and province, a space that unites us in celebration, that fosters our collective learning, and offers a sanctuary for peace reflection, a place that stands for every citizen of Ontario. Ontario Place to me is more than just a landmark. It's a testament of our shared history, our collective memories, our communal hopes, and our unified aspirations. It's our children's laughter echoing off the lakeside. It's the marvel of the cinesphere under the summer stars. It's a place where families and friends gather to enjoy the beauty of the waterfront. But today, my friends, all celebration is twinned with a rallying cry for the Ontario Place we know and love is under threat. There is a proposal to privatize this cherished space, a proposal that stands to shut off the very people who have imbued Ontario Place with life and love for more than half a century. And we're here today to say no more. There's a saying, my friends, there's a saying that goes, change will not come if we wait for some other person or some other time. We are the ones we've been waiting for. We are the change that we seek, and these words echo true for us today. And in this movement, we will not wait for someone else to save Ontario Place. We are the ones we've been waiting for. We are the guardians of this precious public space, the custodians of this city's history, and the champions of its future. And in the spirit of inclusivity, in the spirit of public service, and in the spirit of unity, we say that Ontario Place must remain for all. Let me tell you something. This is not just about preserving a public park. It's about preserving the democratic ideals that we hold dear. Access, equity, and community. Let us remember that Ontario Place was built for us and by us. It was never meant to be an exclusive spa retreat for the few, but a welcoming haven for many. So today, Ontario Place for All calls on you, the people of Ontario, to join us in our movement. We must ensure that Ontario Place remains a place where every child can dream, where every family can gather, and where all are welcome, regardless of their postcode or their pocketbook. Together, let us stand for the Ontario Place that we know and love. Let's fight to keep it public, let's fight to keep it inclusive, and let's fight to keep it ours. For we are not just the guardians of Ontario Place's past, but the architects of its future. We have the power to shape the next 50 years of Ontario Place. Let's shape it as a place for all. Let's make our voices heard, and let's keep Ontario Place for everyone. Thank you. Thank you for being here. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you.
Wow, brilliant, brilliant. Thank you. I mean, a great message, but also great passion and enthusiasm. We want to see that from everybody. Thank you for that. It just inspires us all. I've got one more person to introduce today before we get into the party. Party time, are you ready to party? Yeah! Okay, but first, a very important speaker now. I'm very much pleasure now to welcome Sydney Whitwell. Sydney is a disability activist. She is very concerned about Ontario Place, but when we talk about making Ontario Place for all, she can talk about what that all really means. And I asked her, you know, Sydney, do you represent an organization per se? She says, no, I'm just here because I'm very passionate about it. And she even mentioned people like Emmy that have inspired her. So I want to, I'm inspired to have Sydney come up and speak. Please welcome Sydney Whitwell.
Thank you. When I moved here from Victoria, one of the things that was important to me was a waterfront space. I'm from Vancouver Island, so I'm very used to having access to the ocean. And this is, to me, the perfect space, and it's the perfect space for everyone, and it should remain for everyone. It's the only space that we really have as people who live downtown, I live in Liberty Village, to access the beauty of Ontario and the beauty of the waterfront. And I was so shocked when I met Bruce and he told me that they want to take that from us. It's an accessible space, and it's one that I can get around easily. I come here every single day with my dog. Some of you might have seen me crocheting over there or just going on a walk. And for those of us who use public transit and wheel-trans, we don't have the opportunity to easily access another waterfront space, another forest space. And many people are the same. Many people who live downtown do not own cars. So this should remain for everyone. And when we talk about it remaining for everyone, it's one of the only accessible spaces that we have. Sorry, I'm gonna come up a little bit higher. It's the only accessible space that we actually have as far as some of the other parks. If it's rained recently, then there's no well-paved spaces. There's wide paths here for all manner of people, including parents with strollers, people on bikes. You can even notice the range of people as we've been sitting here and the speakers have been talking, the amount of people that come through here and love this place, and the wide range of people that enjoy it. And when we talk about Ontario Place for All, it's that range of people that deserve to continue to enjoy this space for 50 more years. Thank you.
And thanks again, Sydney. It was really great to hear your message. Thanks. A big hand again for Sydney Whitwell, please. Thank you. That's terrific. Terrific. All right. Well, now we're going to have some fun now. The rally is officially over. All the speeches are officially over. I know, you can hear your sigh of relief. No, it was good messages today. And just a thank you to everybody who took time from the public sector to be here and share their message and share their vision for Ontario Place, because it's going to be a really great when we help get it right. We're going to now ask Sarah Harmer to come on back up and join us, because Sarah is going to lead off a musical program that will also include the Rio Statics and Dom Louie. So we've got a nice little lineup of music here to finish off our afternoon and make it a real, real birthday party. So again, and a big hand to everybody here for being here and supporting this. Thanks. Give yourselves a big hand. Come on, folks. That's what I'm talking about. And now, over to, she's plugging in. She's looking good. I love it. Ladies and gentlemen, friends of Ontario Place, Sarah Harmer.
This is. It's wonderful to see what can happen when we have wonderful architects, the common good in mind, native species, green space, accessible walkways, beautiful docks and rocks and sailboats. I wrote this next song in 2006, and it's a homage to the Niagara Escarpment, so I thought, you know, we're down here on the water, but buffeted behind us there is the ancient Niagara Escarpment, and some of these rocks may have come from the limestone cliffs. And this song is about people coming together to protect land and to protect the commons. If they blow a hole in my backyard, everyone is gonna run away. And the creeks won't flow to the great lake below. Will the water in the well still be okay? If they blow a hole in the backbone, the one that runs across the muscles of the land, oh, we might get a load, a stone for the road, but I don't know how much longer we can stand. We'll need to build some new apartments, and I know we're gonna have to fix the road. If we blow another hole in the escarpment, the wild ones won't have anywhere to go. If they blow a hole in my backyard, everyone is gonna run away. And the creeks won't flow to the great lake below. Will the water in the well still be okay? And we'll keep driving on the blind line. If we don't know where we wanna go, and even knowledge that sound can get watered down, and truth could get sucked out the car window. Truth can get sucked out the car window. What do we really need? The sun and showers, soil and sea. We're two-thirds of water. The aquifer provides. Deep down in the rock, there's a pearl inside. Backbone, the one that runs across the muscles of the land. Oh, we might get a load, a stone for the road, but I don't know how much longer we can stand. Oh, we might get a load, a stone for the road, but I don't know how much longer we can stand.
Thank you. Well, they're not kicking me off the stage right this second, so I'm gonna play one more tune. This one is gonna be dedicated to the tree swallows and the green herons and the leopard frogs and all of the creatures that use this beautiful space. All of the migratory warblers and the herons. Wrote this song. It's a little snapshot of summer in Ontario. Pink fingerlings and Yukon golds dug up and dried on the floor. Little frogs on the front lawn I didn't kill in the mower. Phoebe back to build again above the basement door. Dry owl wings and other things I'm wildly grateful for. September sun, a weekday fun, and being up when cars aren't cruising. A morning mist that slowly lifts in the daylight that we're losing. Cause there's more time with the stars that way. I'll hang on conversations between the queen of Ethiopia and some of her relations. All that I love, pain and
see. Who doesn't love a mystery? Unexpected lunch dates with my sweetheart in the township. Hardly even noticing his depressing surroundings. Cause there's more time with his eyes that way. I'm lost in their affection. The warmest brown is eiderdown. It's sacred ground to rest in. All that I love, rain at night. Shadows that fall in the backyard. Moonlight. Whatever it was we heard in the woods that we might never see. Who doesn't love a mystery? Yukon golds dug up and drying on the floor. Little frogs on the front lawn I didn't kill in the mower. Phoebe back to build again above the basement door. Dry wings and other things I'm wildly grateful for. Thank you. I'm still waiting for the big cane because I think there's some more music coming up. Are you going to introduce? Thank you, everybody. The Rio Statics are coming up shortly. Thanks for all the fight, and I know we can do it together. So thanks for being here.
Big hand for Sarah Harmer. Yeah, talking about it, eh? It's a real pleasure to be here with Sarah Harmer here, and that's just part of the musical event we've got today. Next, we're going to have the Rio Statics. So this is a bit of a band situation, so the gang here is going to set up for the Rio Statics. It's going to take a few minutes, but it doesn't mean the party's over by any means. So while they're setting up, why don't you sit tight and just keep enjoying the vibe, man. It's just so great to be here. A Canadian legend. The Rio Statics have spent more than two decades mapping new frontiers across Canada, embracing the nation that bore them, and reinterpreting its sea to shining sea grandeur and music of startling variety and indisputable beauty. The band has remained fiercely loyal to a unique vision that is entirely dependent upon the special interaction of its members that so fittingly distinguishes the Rio Statics. Their music has been described as variously prog rock, art rock, orchestral psychedelia, and loosely organized cacophony of sound. Wow, can't wait. But at the heart of it, they are thoughtful and they're concerned. Okay, like all of you here, they care. So please, ladies and gentlemen, friends of Ontario Place, join me now in welcoming these musical icons, the Rio Statics. All right.
All right, we're going to do a song we wrote a long time ago during the dark reign of the Mike Harris government. We thought things couldn't get any worse, but they did. So we're going to pull that out and play it for you. It's a beautiful day, though.
Signs been drawn and staked outside PC. I see you trying to lay the blame. The folks in charge hide in shame for growing up with little burrs, yet learning not about guilt. Turn it up. answer unless it's riding on her back. When young and poor go hand in hand, it is a bad time to be poor. It is a bad time to be poor.
Hugh Marsh on violin, everyone.
Dave, I had my first summer job here at Ontario Place, and I worked at a little pizza cart just over yonder. And one day I got swarmed by some bees, so I went outside, and then the pizza started burning, so black smoke was coming out the window. And just then my dad turned the corner with his friend. He was coming to visit me, and I heard him say, "That's my boy." You ready? Don Kerr's gonna sing something.
Woohoo! Yeah? Is this the one we're doing?
Yeah, shall we?
Right on, yeah. Okay, I have this ready to go. Magic, it's magic. Sometimes I'm wrong. My own beliefs are in my soul. A butcher, a banker, a drummer, and then makes no difference what I am. I am everyday people. Yeah, yeah. There is a superstar trying to rip us all off. For different folks, and so on and so on. It's a little bit of sha-sha. We got to live together. I love no better, and neither are you. We're all the same, whatever we do. You love me, you hate me, you know me, and then the waterfront, that's not what the people want. Public park. somewhere else. Ooh, shine. Different folks, and so on and so on, it's you, baby, baby. We got to live together.
Thank you. Do we have time for one more? Dave is asking. Yes? Dave, you want to sing one?
Sure.
Dave Bedini, everyone.
Thanks, Kev. So this park was a gift to us at one point by our province, and now our province is trying to take it away from us. Let's all tell our friends where we were today and what we did, and tell our friends why it's important to protect this jewel of our city. And that's how it starts, folks. Just like this. Just talk to each other, tell your neighbors, tell your friends, because there's time and opportunity and possibility and hope to turn it around. And we can do it, right? Yeah. We can totally do it, because we're awesome.
When he told me to shut off my press, his face turned green, his white shirt was wet, like he'd just seen an accident. We threw our masks into a pile, the trucks pulled away for good. Holy Mackinac Joe, Holy Mackinac Joe. Show. Holy Mackinac Show. Well, a bus pulled in and I waved at it before I knew what it was. We ran in its tracks, we were chasing its tires, but the gate seemed riveted shut. I looked for the foreman, his number was zero, down to Red Deer to stay. We gathered some signs and we sparked up a fire. Yeah, Gordy got burnt on a high voltage wire. Holy Mackinac Show. Nacho. Holy Mackinac. Holy Mackinac. She'll ask me is, how did it go today? And I'll tell her,
Marsh was at the Ontario Place Forum. We came down to see Washboard Hank play open for Jane Siberry. We weren't anti-Jane Siberry or anything, we just really liked Hank. It was Reverend Ken and his lost followers. Anyways, he was playing that night, but before the show, me and Tim, I don't know if, I think maybe somebody else was there too, but we went into the bathroom to drink beer, because that's what you did in 1982. Bathroom was good a place as any to drink beer. So I think we like cracked our two cans of Labatt's Blue or 50 or whatever, when, I don't know, two cops walked into the washroom and subdued us, took our beers, and they wrote us a ticket. We weren't actually arrested. We were able to stay and see the show. Reverend Ken and his lost followers and Hugh Marsh with Jane Siberry. And here we are, many decades later. We're playing with this guy. It's amazing. As if it was fated.
And drinking better beer.
True. It's so great to be playing for you. Let's do more of it right here in this beautiful place.
I thought there was strength in a union. I thought there was strength in a mob. I thought the company was bluffing when they threatened to chop us off. Signs will wilt, the winter will cease. All the bonfires will go out. The company knows when they can afford to be bold. I wish I could, I wish I could, I wish I could. Holy Mackinac Show,
Holy Mackinac,
Holy Mackinac Show, Holy Mackinac Show. We are the horses.
Thanks a lot, folks.
Pretty great. I want to thank you, the Rio Statics, for being here. Big round of applause again for the Rio Statics. Yeah, dude. Fantastic. One more time. Yeah. Guys, thank you very much for being here. Important cause. And you're right. We got to live together. You know, that's just it. And we got to be able to live together and have spaces like this to share. Speaking of this space, we mentioned Norm DePasquale, who's the co-chair of Ontario Place for All. Well, the other half of that chair title is a fellow named Larry Peloso. And this is Larry's baby. So I want to introduce Larry to come on up and just say a few words and really just, you know, revel in the success that all this is happening right now. Thank you. Larry Peloso.
Just a small correction. I'm not a co-chair, but I was sort of came up with this idea and approached Norm with it and said, it's 50 years plus two birthday. And Norm says, okay, let's do it. And he made this happen. Thank you, Norm. Anyway, one other thing that I would dream of making happen right now, and I'm sure all of you feel the same way, because all of you, or many of you, will remember the song, Give Us a Place to Stand. How many people remember the song from Ontario Place? I'd like you to take your phones and put in Ontario Place, Give Us a Place to Stand lyrics, and join me in singing the chorus. All of us, we're gonna do a little flash mob singing of Give Us a Place to Stand. Okay. How many people have got it up yet? I mean, got the lyrics up. Come on, you gotta remember it, eh? Give us a place to stand and a place to grow. And call this land Ontario. You remember that? Okay, now I want you to join in with me. Let's all do it together. I want to hear how loud we can make this, because if there's one way, unfortunately the media's not here now, so social media this is how we stand up for Ontario Place, by singing this song and remembering what this is all about. Okay, if you got the lyrics up there, we'll do it, and on three. One, two. Give us a place to stand and a place to grow and call this land Ontario. A place to live for you and me with hopes as high as the tallest tree. Give us a land of lakes and a land of snow and we will build Ontario. Everybody, a place to stand, a place to grow. Ontario. Thank you.
Thank you, Larry. That was brilliant. Thank you so much. With Dom Lewis and Friends. I want to tell you a little bit about Dom. Dom Lewis is a talented, well, it says talented, but I think you're going to see that's actually true. They didn't just make that up. Singer, songwriter, actually a producer in his own right, self-taught. And he's made a name for himself through his timeless, evocative songwriting, which blends influences of folk, rock, and soul. He's fostered a tight-knit and loyal following with a couple of hits from 2019, Dream On My Baby, and Give It If You Got It. Born and raised in rural southern Ontario. Whereabouts? Which town?
Collingwood.
All right, Collingwood. I love it. There you go. He's part of the Ontario experience, and he picked up the guitar when he was just a kid, and he began teaching himself songs at the age of 10 and writing songs. He played at local fairs and community halls. Self-taught multi-instrumentalist. He was raised on classic artists like Neil Young, Bob Dylan, and then developed a love for many classic and contemporary artists, ranging from the Beatles to Jeff Buckley. So you got a real nice, solid background there. I'm looking forward to hearing this. Dom's music cuts deep with honesty and soothes the listener with its warm, bittersweet soul, perfect for moments of heartache, uncertainty, and hope in our times. That's what we need today, is some hope, because we want to make Ontario Place work for everybody. And Dom and Lewis and Friends are going to be here now to share some music and their hope for that future. Ladies and gentlemen, Dom Lewis.
Thank you so much, mate.
Oh, we're so happy to be here. What a beautiful turnout. What a beautiful day.
Mama, don't fence me yet.
a man of too many words, but I've been coming here since I was a kid, and I'm honored to get to be a part of this today of such a great cause. And yeah, it's really wonderful to see so many people turn up. Dreams, but holding on to hope, so hopefully that's pertinent.
Thunder clouds rolling around in my mind. I ain't sleeping it off tonight. Stare them down like I'm squaring them off for a fight. Pull you close in there, look in your eyes, and I break.
outside. How we doing out there? This is another song about hope. It's called Down Every Road. It's about going the distance, and no matter what that road is, good times, bad times, it sounds of something like this. Let the sun come in, let the birds that sing hold you from afar. Anywhere you are, 49, 10 days, 10 full miles away, your secret in my heart. Down every road, down every road. Won't sing, and I'm up behind the bars. I'm still where you are. Take it on a sunny day at Ontario Place. Hold it in your heart. Down every
saints.
boys home. As heaven's angels carried her away, I will follow you to Virgie, although it hurts me so to lay to rest this mountain beauty that the Lord's called home. I can see her up in glory. I can see her through the pines. We're trying to make sense of all these streams. I can see her in the corner singing along to all our crazy dreams. I will follow you to Virgie, although it hurts me so to lay to rest this mountain beauty that the Lord's called home. And I can see her up in glory. I can see her through the pines. I will follow you to Virgie, 'cause that's what us boys are for, to help you out when you get weary. You can't go no more. Can't you see her up there, Cody? I can see her through the pines. Singing, boys, be good.
Tyler Childers song, if there's any fans out there.
Teach me love and teach me light, babe. Red and purple, blue and gold. Ask me no questions, I'll tell you no lies. Where I've been ain't where I'm going. I'm flying away tonight to Carolina. This time tomorrow I'll be out of sight. Found a little light inside my mind, babe. My silver lining in the dead of night, where the colors shine and the stars take flight. 'Cause we can't tell the sunrise to wait another night. I'll hold you till the crow flies, time gonna dry your eyes. Some people tell you to be open. Some people tell you to be whole. But I've never felt quite so all alone. Everything that dies is made of stone. I'm flying away tonight to Carolina. This time tomorrow I'll be out of sight. Found a little light inside my mind, babe. My silver lining in the dead of night, where the colors shine and the stars take flight. 'Cause we can't tell the sunrise to wait another night. I'll hold you till the crow flies, time gonna dry your eyes. Thank you. the dead of night, where the colors shine and the stars take flight. Cause we can't tell the sunrise to wait another night. I'll hold you till the crow flies, time gonna dry your eyes.
Norm, wherever. How are we doing for time, Norm? We got a time for a couple more? All right, on.
Silhouette in mind, you were the vision of a different time. Your face lit up so bright, it burns all night, it burns all night. Dream on, my baby, just cause you ain't by my side. Dream on, my baby, in the dark of night. Distant friend, you're drifting on again, and in some forward land you find a hand to help ignite the fire. It takes all night, it takes all night. Dream on, my baby, just cause you ain't by my side. Dream on, my baby, don't mean you ain't on my mind. Dream on, my baby, in the dark of night.
I'll just say one last time how honored we are to be a part of this. And such a beautiful event. And we got one more song for you. Thank you, guys.
lights aglow. Each way is empty, it's so hard to see which is home. You're standing out in the ocean, fear gripping at your bones. And I'm sitting here in silence until someone begs the violins, take it away. Then you get yourself together. Get yourself together. Then you get yourself together. Get yourself together for me, babe. Isn't turning around like it once did before. Roads that you walked on ain't fit for your feet anymore. You're standing in a commotion, fear's knocking at your door. And my weary eyes are crying now until someone begs the silence, take the day. Then you get yourself together. Get yourself together. Then you get yourself together. Get yourself together for me, babe.
Thank you guys so much. Have a great rest of your day.
Wow, fantastic. A big round of applause for Dom Lewis and friends. That was great, guys. Really great. Thank you. We've come to the end of our program today, and I just want to remind everyone that it's one thing to count on the MPPs and the politicians and the people that are doing stuff to make things happen, but the change comes from all of us. Just remember that. We just need all of you behind this. So let's have a big round of applause for all of us here today for being here and wanting to make a difference. All right. It's all about accountability, accessibility, and transparency. Let's hope for that. And now I just want to bring on the co-chair of Ontario Place for All, the fellow whose baby this is, and just to say some final words, Norm DePasquale. Thank you.
Thank you, Michael, and thank you, everyone, for coming, and thank you for the Ontario Place for All Steering Committee and all of the volunteers. And I'd like to try to call up the Ontario Place Steering Committee and volunteers up here so that we can thank you properly for all of your time and efforts today. Our movement has got incredible momentum. We have just blown, we are heading right towards 20,000 letters sent to the Premier, the interim mayor, and King of Surma, telling people that this place matters, and it matters to all of you. So please, go to OntarioPlaceForAll.com. Please grab a sign from the table back there and put it in your window. Let people know that Ontario Place matters to you. We need to spread the word big, loud, and fast, and you can all help us to do this. So thank you. Thank you all. Please go get a sign. Talk to your friends. David Crombie once told me to talk to 5 of my friends about the jets at the Island Airport. And before I knew it, I spoke to 500 people, and we stopped the jets at the Island Airport. We can win this fight too, but we really need people power, and we need you to talk to your relatives all across Ontario. Let's get this movement big, strong, and undeniable so that the government has no choice but to back down and make this a public space for everyone. Hey, here's the Ontario Place for All Steering Committee. Thank you all for all of your hard work in making this a dream a reality. You know, we heard from Larry. Hey, There we go. We heard from Larry Peloso, who you heard from like a couple of weeks ago, hey, why don't we throw a birthday party for Ontario Place? And the idea was born. And then, you know, 2 weeks later, here we are and here you all are. So thank you for coming out in the numbers you did. Thank you very much. And thank you to the awesome steering committee who put in so much time over these last 2 weeks to make this event a reality. Thank you, each and every one of you. I want to go back just for a minute to the birth of Ontario Place and, you know, just talk about what the Ontario government was thinking at the time and local politicians. The Ontario government initially considered calling this place the Ontario Showcase, which gives us a clear intention of what they were thinking for this site. They wanted to focus on Ontario's people and resources and celebrate and reflect Ontario. How does an Austrian spa do that? Ontario Place evolved into a landmark to showcase Ontario's people and resources with flair. For the architect, Eb Seidler, who architected the Cinesphere and the Pods and other places, it represented a chance to spark the development of the waterfront, to create a lasting legacy for young people who had to stay in the big city during the summer. Now, how does an Austrian spa help with that? Here's a quote from Bill Davis from 52 years ago on the grand opening of Ontario Place. It's a stimulating and permanent symbol of the work and achievement of the people of Ontario. The vision and scope of Ontario Place gives promise to our vast potential. There reposes here a part of the soul and spirit of all the thousands of towns and villages, farms and mining camps, urban high-rises and suburban homes which continue to make Ontario. How does an Austrian spa reflect that? Said then Trade Minister Alan Grossman, it may help us to cease our self-analysis and just be what we are. How does an Austrian spa do that? I want to thank everyone. This concludes the Ontario Place birthday celebration. I am so grateful you all have taken the time to be here today and enjoy a beautiful Victoria Day together. I hope everybody enjoyed the cake. There is a paddle event happening at West Island. If anybody wants to see that, there's a swimming group holding that. I understand there might be a mayoral candidate too. But otherwise, just enjoy the space, folks. And thank you all so much for coming out today and sending an undeniable message that Ontario Place matters to you. Thank you.
Oh,